Well, we knew they wouldn't let us down. So far, this has been a fantastic Tokyo night at the darts. The semi-finals, Anderson against Lewis and Van Gerwen against James Wade. But this has been some night already, with the promise to get even better. Outstanding performance from Anderson in beating Raymond van Barneveld earlier. Anderson chasing his third World Series title this year. Adrian Lewis, who won in Auckland last year, more than capable of upsetting the world champion here. Four great players, two terrific semi-finals, but only one winner here in Tokyo.
And a bit of playful rough and tumble between these two on stage just at the start. This one, Stokey Sumo from Adrian Lewis here in Tokyo.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. First leg, Gary, to throw first. Game on!
A repeat of the World Championship final, of course, the one where Gary Anderson claimed his second consecutive world title. Beat Adrian Lewis at Ali Pali, 7-5. Great final it was as well.
136.
This promises much. I'm sure it will deliver. If they stand and deliver on the hockey in Tokyo, it's a great effect. Anderson averaging around 104, far too good for van Barneveld. Lewis came back brilliantly to beat Peter Wright. There's no reason to believe that that standard won't be maintained here.
And these two won't hang around either. They should be able to get into a nice little rhythm. No gamesmanship up there. Two good mates, actually.
100. Gary, you require 100.
Maybe not as good mates as those two. Travel 17.
So a chance for Lewis.
57. Maybe you require 125.
Both with the first one. Well, travel 20. So this important first leg. 65. Can Anderson hold on?
Gary, you
hold his throw.
64.
8 for double top. Wow, going for double 16. Not his usual 48. MO, and he misses Adrian inside on the 60. Doubles. Adrian Lewis to break the throw in the very first leg. Double top he wants. Down for double 10.
40.
Missed Gary chance early 16. On from AD Lewis. Double 8 for Anderson. It isn't his favourite bit of the board, this.
Score.
I think that he actually missed the big eight when he originally was going for eight, or he hit the 16 to leave the double rather than eight to leave tops, and he's paying the price here. Four missed darts at double. Anderson's finishing against Van Barneveld in the quarterfinal was so good. Barley just didn't get a sniff, but four missed darts at double, and Lewis breaks.
Well, whether it was by accident or design, he still paid the penalty, Gary Anderson. But you know what? When things go a little bit wrong, usually spurs him on to produce better stuff. Maybe just what he needs.
Never in doubt. Anderson in a spot of bother here. Great friends, these two. Not for the next half hour. Nevertheless, Anderson with four missed darts at double. Different complex on the semi-final now. Not enough.
You require 85.
11 darter. Look where Anderson is.
Yeah, some way back is the answer. Adrian Lewis will come back looking at double 5.
60.
For 2-0, and Anderson just hasn't got going.
2-0. How important are those missed doubles from the world champion in the first leg going to be? Long way to go. He's starting from here, you feel. get into this semi-final. 180 from Anderson.
99. 100.
Anderson beat Lewis in the final in Auckland last month.
131.
Lovely pace. The semi-final being played at
95.
85. Has got an important win over Gary of late. Adrian Lewis did so in the Premier League to assure himself a place in the playoffs. Beat him 7-2. Anderson just looking to set this up as best
94.
He can. Well, that will leave him double 16, and that's kind of where things went a bit wrong for him in the first leg, so he's got an opportunity
42.
To make amends.
Gary, you require 32.
No mistake this time.
Third leg. Gary Anderson.
And needed to get on the board. Terrific night so far here in 57. Tokyo. All the drama. Not more so than that final quarter-final when Phil Taylor had led all the way. He missed three darts to win
76.
In a deciding leg. James Wade, the only time he was ahead in the entire match was when he hit double four in the deciding leg. Hence James
57.
Wade against Michael van Gerwen to come.
James Wade, just a play. Philly just needs a pace setter, somebody who can just drag him along, and then right at the end he just nips in front, steps in, thank you very much, shake of hands. You can just sit the rest of the tournament out, mate.
42.
Another one of those gets Anderson to a finish.
100.
Has to settle for the ton. Fighting back after a pretty lethargic opening couple of legs from the
57.
World champion, but it's certainly gone off the boil for Edie Lewis as well.
Yeah, Lewis has turned to struggle.
174.
Say no more. 174.
This is more like it from these two. 174, 180, double 18 straight in. This is what we've come to expect from these men.
13 darts at a break. Anderson two down. He is back level.
140.
You mentioned the World Championship final. Absolute cracker. As their first one was in 2011 when Lewis won 7-5, but I think they always come up with some great games. As I mentioned before, the pace is just perfect. The rhythm of both of them to get into it, and they just get on with it, don't they?
Yeah, there's none of the 57. Other factors that might come into play that obstructs them from finding their top form. They don't always hit the very heights of their
65.
Form when they play each other, but
Gary,
you require
164.
Would think they've got more chance of doing so against each other than they have against other opponents.
Huge amount of respect as well
60.
Between them. Yep, to leave a finish.
100. Gary, you
104. 104. Can Anderson go ahead for the first time? He'll stay there.
88.
Well, he sets it up nicely, but this is gettable. Keeps pulling that first dart down, Adrian Lewis, and that makes things
96.
Immediately a lot harder for
Gary,
him.
Gary, you require 16.
He's on the left side of the board again here, Anderson.
In charge of fifth leg.
Doesn't seem to matter. The blip of the first leg when he missed four darts. Since then, he's been
100.
Perfect. Three legs on the spin, winning double with the first dart on each occasion.
81.
It's so much about mental strength and fortitude these World Series days, when the tournament's only over a couple of days and they've got to win three big games against top-class opponents. Mental strength is just as important as the natural ability and skill they show on the hockey.
You know, these guys play at the Pro Tour events away from the crowds all the time, and they're playing multiple games in a day, but different demands on you when you've got the walk-ons and the crowd and all the adrenaline and everything that goes with it when you're playing big stage darts in front of the TV cameras.
62.
Well, important last dart, but it still doesn't leave him a finish. Two single ones. A great visit from Anderson. One or two loose ones coming into play as far as Lewis is concerned. Is it going to be four legs on the spin for Anderson? Not the best lie for him. Doesn't matter. It's four legs on the spin. And Anderson from two down.
Gary to throw first. Game on.
Is throwing to go 5-2 up.
Well, it's been good from Anderson, these last four legs, but it's also been down to some scrappy stuff from Lewis that has just opened the door for him.
57.
Just the 57 again, and right now, you think there's only one winner of this game. It's one-way traffic at the moment.
Well, there is a break in the semi-finals and the final here in Tokyo after seven legs, and
100.
The way things are looking, it'll be a much-needed break for Adrian Lewis. It'll come at the wrong time for Gary Anderson.
He would love, absolutely love, to just carry on playing through to the culmination of this game, because I think without the break, it might not be very far away, because
95.
Adrian Lewis is struggling at the moment. And Anderson will just look to set this up to return for a 5-2 lead at the break.
98.
And that is exactly what he would have wanted.
Average pushed up to around about 100 now, Anderson. Lewis is 10 points behind that. So Anderson here. That was a poor one. That wasn't the best. Well, that was the classic Gary Anderson there. Last dart in hand. And it's five consecutive legs for the world champion. He looks to be on his way to the final here in Tokyo. We shall see. Don't go anywhere. Anderson leads 5-2 against Adrian Lewis.
And has a commanding but not insurmountable lead against Adrian Lewis, the man he beat in the World Championship final back in January at Ali Pali. Anderson needs three more legs. Lewis has stayed out there during the break, practicing, trying to summon up something that can turn the tide in this one. But it will have to be considerable against a man who only needs to get to eight to book his place in the final.
81.
Yeah, measure of Gary Anderson, and we've talked about this during this event here in Tokyo and during the World Series as well. The amount of times that he hits double five after missing tops and double ten in a combination 85. With three darts in his hand, and it's made the difference in so many big games that he's played. You can never question his accuracy on the treble 20.
But it is overwhelmingly the fact that he hits those double flash darts that has turned him from a guy who could be a world champion to a man who's won it 2 years running.
Yeah. Well, from the nearly man to the man.
41.
Said it many times, but Lewis has achieved it in this era as well. But to win back-to-back world championships in the most competitive era in the history of professional darts is just
77.
Incredible.
Gary, you require 140.
Well, this would be some way to return from the break for Gary Anderson. Double 10. 6-2. And maybe Adrian Lewis' hopes of firing back strongly after the break have just been extinguished by that moment of brilliance from the world champion.
He looks in the mood, doesn't he? He looks in the mood for another World Series title. You got that feeling when he was playing Barney. And here, Adrian Lewis, well, he's just got to play with some freedom. Stop thinking about it and play.
83.
Well, the
86.
The sponsors put up the bonus of £50,000 for a 9-darter. It's never really looked like being threatened so far. Through the best darts you'll ever see. Fantastic grouping.
And there's a 180 back at you, but Anderson's on 98 to go within a leg of the final. Treble 18 does not get it, so Lewis. 55 has to go, Adrian. It has to go. Double 10. Oh, that is a mile away.
Well, that was effectively, that was to stay in it. Anderson here looking to put him out of it. Double 10.
Wow. Right on the wire, but not good enough. That's where he needed to put it, and Adrian Lewis does stay alive in this one. It's a breaker throw as well, but he needs a lot more.
He needs two more breaks of throw, but he's playing with freedom. How often do you see this when it looks like a player's well out of it, no pressure, and starts playing properly, playing with real freedom? Hit 2 180s in that ninth leg, but still could and maybe should have lost it.
66.
Well, look, Taylor missed three match darts against James Wade. We saw Dave Chisnell miss opportunities against Michael Van Gerwen. Maybe those three darts from Gary Anderson for 7-2, could they prove to be a turning
85.
Point? Some way away from that happening, but there's still an opportunity for Jackpot and his fans. Have something to cheer for in the final.
It's been a great legged response, hasn't it? Anderson leaving 96 after 9 to hit straight back and break Lewis again. If he can, he'll be throwing for the match in the next leg. Lewis responds again. Well, he went for the treble 16. That would have left double 14. That's a strange one.
66.
Well, he's left himself there.
That was 15. 30, yeah,
he wanted 20 for double top, but yeah. Bit of a miscount there.
It's made a mess of that. Oh, and he could pay the price. It isn't over yet. Gary Anderson there. Miscounting. We actually saw him do that a couple of times during the World Championship final at the Alexandra Palace. It's happened here.
96.
How much damage will it do?
Yeah, he'll say it's his vision, but I'm not sure you can blame it there.
96.
And little things like that contribute to losing a leg, and in a short format game, it could... offer 40. Adrian Lewis a way back into the match, but if you go and score 40, that is not going to help your cause. Certainly not now. Certainly not now! As Anderson fires in his fourth maximum of the match, his 11th of this tournament. Leaves himself 85, potentially 11 darts are coming in here for 7-4.
Tops he needs. Well, no doubt about that. I think he was angry, wasn't he? He got himself angry by making a mess of the last leg. 11 darter. Oh, special leg from a special player, and he needs one more. Lewis needs four more. Got to win the lot.
115.
There is no room for error for Adrian Lewis anymore, and there was nothing wrong with that. Five maximums for Lewis, four for Gary Anderson. Anderson is now averaging in excess of 105 Oh, what a leg of darts this is. Hit with an 11 darter. Lewis is on a 10 darter here.
Believe a finish. Double nine. Oh, double two it was. It was all around the board. For a 12 darter on double two. Anderson now throwing for the match. That'll do nicely for starters. 10 on 80s in the semi-final.
Oh, a bark of frustration from Adrian Lewis. He said there's no room for error. That was a bit of bad luck. But it could well prove 45. Fatal. Oh, just the 45 from Gary Anderson. Needs more. Gets more.
34.
Adrian Lewis battling away here.
100.
Well, it's been another great semi-final. Anderson dominating at 6-2. Possibly should have been 7-2 up, but Lewis, 100. With the shackles off, has come back strongly. He's won three of the last four legs, but it may be the end of the road for Adrian Lewis here.
36.
Brilliant leg from Anderson. Possible 13 data for a place in the Tokyo final.
He averaged 103 against Raymond van Barneveld and was very impressive. He was walking, he thought he had the job done. It's not quite done yet, Gary. Double 10, double 5. It was inevitable, wasn't it? Inevitable, last start in hand. He's averaged more than 104 there, Gary Anderson. His impressive form continues here in Tokyo. The world champion is in the final and has a chance to make it three World Series titles in 2016. Who's he going to face? Well, we'll find that out very shortly. It's either the world number one, Michael van Gerwen, or the conqueror of Phil Taylor, James Wade.